What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about how to configure vSAN fault domains. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is log into our vSphere web portal. We are going to click on our cluster. Within cluster, we are going to go to configure, and within configure, we're going to go all the way down to the vSAN section and then click on fault domains. Now, for this video, I have two standalone hosts. And the only thing that I'm going to do is select 140 and then drag it to the plus and then just drop it. It's going to give you a nice little dialog box to give your fault domain a name. I gave it the following fault domain name and I clicked on create. I did the same thing to 141, just click, drag it, and drop it, and then give it a name. Now from here, if you look at the right-hand side, you should see an option that says configure stretch clusters. If you click on that, you're going to get the configure stretch clustered wizard. Now I forgot to show you guys behind the scenes, I added a third hypervisor to my cluster. So if you take a closer look on the left-hand side, you're going to see the IP address is 192.168.94.130. That hypervisor is actually going to be my witness host for this stretch cluster. So, okay, let's get back into the configure stretch cluster wizard. I'm going to basically select 141, and 141, I'm just going to click on the arrow to bring it over to the secondary because that is my secondary domain, and we are going to click on next there. Now it's time to select our witness host. So I'm going to expand my hypervisor, expand my data center, and then select my witness host, which is 130. But I receive an error that there's no VM kernel adapter on that hypervisor. So I went back to 130, I went to configure, I went to networking, and I clicked on VM kernel adapters. Within here, within the VM kernel adapters, I created a vSAN service adapter. And once I configured that, I went back into the configure stretch cluster wizard, and I was able to select this hypervisor with no problem, which is a good thing. So we are able to click on next. Now it's time for us to select our cache tier as well as our capacity tier. And once you select all that stuff, just click on next. A nice little review, click finish, and you're done. Awesome. So now we have a witness host, which for me, it is 130 within my vSAN infrastructure. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.